please access the ReMoCapp documentation website using the provided link. Click the Get Started button to be redirected to the Tutorials section. On the Tutorials page, you will find various learning resources related to ReMoCapp, as well as any associated plugins and applications. The Getting Started section is designed to help you prepare for your first motion capture session using ReMoCapp. Since you have already installed the application and activated it using the license key obtained from the website, you can skip the installation and activation steps. Instead, scroll down to the section on Starting a Motion Capture Session. In this section, you will find an information box that provides the necessary steps for configuring the app. Click on the Camera Positioning link for detailed instructions. The page will provide you with useful information on connecting, positioning, and orienting your cameras. We recommend arranging your cameras as shown in the accompanying images, based on the number of cameras you intend to use. Before moving on to the next section, please read the information on this page and position your cameras accordingly. Once you have positioned your cameras, the next step is to calibrate them. To begin the camera calibration process, please click on the Camera Calibration link. This page provides a detailed explanation of the camera calibration and scene setup process. For the calibration process, you will need two printed pieces of paper, the chessboard and the origin marker images. The links to download these files are provided on the page. Please download and print the files and affix the papers onto a flat cardboard surface. On this page, you will find instructions on how to measure the lengths of the chessboard and origin marker images. Make sure to have the measured numbers ready, as we will be using them to set certain properties in the application. Now, go to the Application Settings tab and set the measured lengths of the chessboard and origin marker that you obtained earlier. Since we're using two cameras in portrait orientation, we select the layout that shows two vertical bars. Select the layout that best suits your needs. Next, navigate to the Camera Settings tab. Start by selecting the left frame and choose a camera from the drop-down list of currently available cameras. You will see the camera output displayed in the frame. We set the rotation to 270 degrees to ensure the appropriate camera output. Proceed to select the right frame and pick the other available camera from the list. Similarly, we rotate this frame by 270 degrees as well. Now, select the left frame once again and click the Calibrate button. This will open the Camera Calibration window. Use the previously printed and affixed chessboard paper to calibrate the camera. Ensure that the entire chessboard is visible to the camera and move it gradually so that the red dots cover all the grid tiles. As each tile turns green, move on to the next one until all tiles are green. Once you complete the calibration, you can save the calibration result by clicking the Save button. Next, select the right frame. Since we're using two cameras with the same properties and specifications, we can use the calibration data from the first camera for the second camera. First, export the calibration data to a file by selecting the left frame again and clicking the Save button in the Camera Calibration section. The file name will be automatically set based on the camera name and resolution. Click Save to create the file. Now, you can use the calibration data in the configuration file and load it onto the camera associated with the right frame. This way, both cameras will use the same calibration data. If you're using different cameras, you can calibrate each one just as we did for the first camera. The next step is to perform the scene setup. Before proceeding, ensure that the paper used for the setup is visible to all the cameras, maintaining an appropriate distance. And it should not be moved while the scene setup process is being performed for all the cameras. Here, we've placed the origin marker paper with the front axis pointing to the opposite direction of the whiteboard. And as you see, it's almost aligned with the floor. That makes it easier to see whether the ground level and slope are detected correctly or not. With the left frame selected, click the Set button in the Scene Setup section. This will open the setup window. If the camera calibration process was done properly, a grid will be drawn aligned to the floor, and the scene axis will be set. The front axis will be displayed as a red line. Click the Save button. You can also export and import scene setup data for each camera using the Save and Load buttons, respectively. Note that scene setup needs to be performed separately for each camera, even if they are of the same brand and model. Keep the position and direction of the origin marker paper unchanged as you proceed to set up other cameras. You will need to perform the scene setup for all the cameras again if any changes are made to the position or direction of the origin marker paper. Also, if the orientation or position of a camera is changed, you need to do the scene setup for that camera again. Please be aware that switching USB ports for similar cameras may result in different camera names being detected when you open the application next time. In such cases, make sure to load the appropriate configuration file for the affected cameras. This is particularly important if you plan to load scene setup data at a later time, as changes to the origin marker or any of the cameras has made the scene setup configuration file incorrect. Finally, select the right frame and click the Set button. Once the grid is set properly, click the Save button.